So after the Northern Line extension has been built, should be the new Crossrail stations, then the new London Overground station, and then what's the next new station in London? Well, it should be the opening of Brent Cross West, that's located in northwest London as part of the Thameslink network. The new station is part of a huge regeneration taking place in the area known as the Brent Cross Cricklewood development. That's a £4.5 billion programme that's being undertaken by Barnet Council that will bring a bus station, hotel, cinema and many new homes to the area. The new station will sit between the existing Cricklewood and Hendon stations and be served by Thameslink services to and from Luton and St Albans. It sits alongside the Midland Main Line, and whilst both Hendon and Cricklewood will remain open, the new Brent Cross West will be built with longer platforms that can accommodate 12-car trains. Now, if you take in an aerial view on Google Earth, you can see the location of a train maintenance depot here. This is Cricklewood carriage sidings, and along with a nearby freight facility, these will be relocated nearby to make space for the new station. There'll be an entrance on the western side and on the eastern side with a new pedestrian bridge that will be open for 24 hours a day for local access, and the ticket office and access down to the platforms will then be from that. And there's one other interesting thing to note here for the future. Now it's probably many years away, but nearby there is a freight-only line known as the Dudding Hill Line which runs through Gladstone Park and has two curves of track that join up with the line between the new Brent Cross West and Cricklewood. There's a proposal known as the West London Orbital Line, which would see it become part of the London Overground, with services running up from Hounslow through Acton and then split with trains going to both Hendon and West Hampstead. Brent Cross West Station has to be built first though, and at the moment it's on schedule to be completed by the end of 2022, and it may appear on next year's Tube Map as well.